All right, some good news and bad news for commuters using the EDSA bus carousel. A new bus stop was opened today, just days before government ends its subsidy for the free bus rides. Our very own Jackie Manabat now joins us with that story. Jackie, over to you.
Carmina, the EDSA bus carousel will no longer offer free bus rides starting January 1 at 5 a.m. The Department of Transportation says that as much as they want to extend the free ride service, they have budgetary constraints. The Department of Budget and Management removed the proposed $12 billion budget for the free rides in the National Expenditure Program for, for 2023 submitted to Congress. Instead, the transport agency was given 1.2 billion pesos for the contracting service program. The government pays around 10 to 12 million pesos daily to bus concessionaires to run 600 to 700 buses conveying about 400,000 passengers. The Land Transportation Franchising Regulatory Board still needs to release a fare matrix for the EDSA bus carousel. However, based on the previous rates charged by the said route, the fare will be 13 pesos for the first 5 kilometers, then an additional 2 pesos and 20 centavos for every 6 succeeding kilometer. The EDSA bus carousel traverses from Caloocan City to PITX in Parañaque City, with 21 bus stops, with a triple bus stop in Pasay City as the latest addition. According to the Department of Transportation, EDSA bus carousel has reduced the 2 to 3 hour travel time for commuters from Pasay to Caloocan down to an hour and a half. Bautista said that privatizing the EDSA bus carousel operations is on this list for 2023, and there are already interested groups, according to Bautista, for non-submitted 8 proposals. Since 2020, the government has spent 551 billion pesos on the infrastructure of the EDSA busway. The EDSA bus carousel was rolled out by the Duterte administration during the height of the pandemic. Back to you, Carmina.
All right, Jackie, that seems to be good news, privatizing it, but at the end of the day, it's going to really boil down to how much the eventual winning bid will charge all the commuters, Jackie.
You're right, Carmina. That's why the Department of Transportation is already preparing the terms of reference. That part of their wish list for 2023 is to privatize it. One of the terms Bautista mentioned a while ago is that the passengers should be provided comfort, such as there would be tarps or there would be seats while waiting for the buses, and just, you know, providing comfort for the passengers. But now that there's no fare matrix yet for the EDSA bus carousel, the Department of Transportation says they are sure that the fare for the EDSA bus carousel will be affordable for the 400,000 passengers daily riding the said route. Carmina?
Yes, and Jackie, I think the last time we talked, you also mentioned about how the DOTR has allocated some budget for the betterment of the riding experience in terms of infrastructure that's needed. Like when you talk about the EDSA bus carousel, we know that passengers would have to cross the highway just to get to their docking point, and that's sort of inconvenient for our commuters. But the last time we talked, you said that this may be a way, or there may be a way, or there's budget allocated so that the government can provide the necessary infrastructure for the commuters, at least for the EDSA bus carousel system, Jackie.
That's right, Carmina, because currently the passengers need to go through the walkways, the footbridges. It will take like minutes to reach the buses. And there's a long line, there's a long queue, especially during rush hours in the morning and at night. And that's an inconvenience, especially to passengers who are senior citizens or those with disabilities. Now with the 1.2 billion peso budget given to the Department of Transportation, Bautista said a while ago that they will look into this budget and study on how much will be given or will be given to the ETSA busway for its upgrade. There are plans to put up a better bus stop and comfort rooms and seats for those who are waiting for the buses. Carmina.
And talking about adding bus stops, I understand that they asked added a new bus stop in Tramo in Pasay.
Yes, you're right. That's the 21st bus stop for EDSA Carousel, and they plan to add more bus stops. And this is the middle of EDSA, so a passenger still has to go up the footbridge and down again to reach the buses here at the Pasay Tramo. And that's the reason why the Department of Transportation is looking into this new budget of 1.2 billion pesos and how they could ease the experience or how could they make the experience better for the passengers of the EDSA bus carousel.
And how many passengers are they going to hopefully service with this new bus stop that was added in Pasay?
Right now, the EDSA bus carousel is servicing 400,000 passengers. And with the new bus stop, they are expecting around 2,000 more passengers. That's why they are asking the bus concessionaires to add more buses to the line. Currently, they have around 600 buses on the line. So they are asking the bus concessionaires to add 10 or 20 more to the bus route, Carmina.
Yeah, and one other thing about the privatization of this EDSA bus carousel, Jackie, we understand that there's no one company that's doing this right now. There are several companies that have fielded their units there. Once it is privatized, are we going to see more of the same, or is it just really going to be one entity that will be operating the whole route of the EDSA bus carousel? And how many units does the government think this whole system needs for it to really serve the public better, Jackie?
Well, Bautista said a while ago that they are opening the bid to several, to a lot of private companies, just like what happened to LRT1, for example. LRT1 is now owned and operated by a private company. Now, the operations will be the operations for the EDSA busway will be under that private company. However, the bus stops will still be operated by the government. And with the bus concessionaires, there are currently two bus concessionaires running along the EDSA bus route. And Bautista said they're open to welcoming more bus lines into the EDSA bus carousel.
Okay, so it's not going to be like operated by just one entity. They're open to several entities, maybe a whole organization. It's just basically just what we're seeing right now, Jackie. Only that it's really going to be them who's running the show, these bus concessionaires, Jackie.
You're right. The operations, if privatized, if EDSA Bus Carousel will be privatized, the operations of the bus routes will be under the private companies to several bus lines, while the bus stops will still be operated by the government. That's what DOTR is looking at right now.
All right. Thanks a lot. Jackie Manabat there joining us on the line.